this, this part, this house, and the, this shape of the room, the space, is actually the most, one of the most important feature for the garden. Alnarp Rehabilitation Garden started in 2002, and it is Professor Patrick Grant's idea, and together with a great group of people, he managed to design and actually build this garden. This is a living lab where you actually have people in live real life situation. And at that time when they started, there was this really mysterious problem with health problem that people get kind of called burnout, and it's an exhaustion disorder. So his original idea was to create space and a garden with where you incorporate all kinds of theories and ideas about how nature can be supportive. And he has this theory of supportive environment theory, how we can build different kinds of space that support health. So that was the original idea, with meaningful activities. It's important as well. So it's like the mix of doing and being in a supportive environment. This living lab is based on two teams, you could say. The team that is working in the garden with the activities, and us team, research team, that are like doing the evaluation, both qualitative and quantitative. And we have a close relationship and work closely together when we, for example, are designing new intervention program for new group. We have done three different groups: stress-related mental disorder 2002 to 2012, then post-stroke rehabilitation for mental fatigue, and then now we have newly arrived migrants that are doing vocational rehabilitation. And activities, what do we do here? What they do here?
We do everything. We take care of the garden all the year round. So we do meaningful activities that has to be done. If we don't do it in the groups, we, like me and my colleague, we have to do it. So we do everything, like from watering all the plants to this, yeah, with the working with the seeds, harvest, plant new plants and flowers. So, and now we're preparing for the new season. So it depends where we are during the year, what has to be done. Yeah.
We work with stakeholders in the real society, you could say. So we are not just sitting and doing our research and then just writing papers and throwing it out, but it's a joint work. For example, now with the Swedish Employment Office. And then when we finished with the evaluation of this concept, we're going to implement it so they can use it in their everyday work. We quite often say like the urban environment and the peri-urban environment, and they're like quite separate things, but actually as the cities and the towns are getting bigger and bigger and they're taking over landscape and area that actually are farming land, it could also be thoughtful to think about save the farms and not just build on the mark, or and then connect them to the urban environment, inviting school kids, elderly, whatever. There are a lot of possibilities, so you don't have to build a new garden, but you can use the farms as we are like this sprawl is like taking over. But I think for future perspective, this garden was created as a rehab garden or healing garden, but it has so much more potential because you could actually use the environment for any target group. You can use nature pedagogic and all kinds of other experimental where you work with the movable lab that is looking at different physical reaction in the environment. So you can have a heart rate and look at the size of the pupils when you're walking around. And so there are a lot of possibilities, and we would like to, we are a group that are working for opening up and want to invite more researchers to come in. So it's not just intervention and rehab, but we want to open it as an arena for everybody, all the researchers here in SLU to come in, to use the facilities. And it doesn't have to be rehab.